Gewässer ist auch dann nicht und dann nicht mehr flüssig. Dann ist der Wasserberg in die Leiter an die Mond, wenn die Tankstellenwasser noch still ist. It is now being recognized as a critical metallurgical reactor in which a series of operations authors that is fast and thermal and physical control. Tannish is a rectangular beaten up reflective line open container which may have a reflective line cover on the top. It is used to transfer liquid steel from a steel ladder to the mold. It is used to feed liquid steel into the upper molds of the CC machine so as to avoid splashing and leave a smoother flow. The bottom of the tannish has one or more holes with slide plates or stopper rods for controlling the flow of liquid steel in the mold. And it serves the purpose of a reservoir and a distributor vessel. It ensures the feed of the liquid steel to the CC machine during the change of ladders, thus acting as a buffer of the steel, liquid steel. Then it delivers liquid steel to the mold evenly and at a desired throughput rate and temperature without causing contamination by intrusions. It smoothens outflow, regulates steel feed to the mold, and cleans the metal. Metal remains left inside a tannish are known as tannish cells and is removed typically by mechanical means, scraping or cutting. There have been dramatic changes in tannish over the years from a mere reservoir and distribution vessel. Tannish today is used as a steel refining vessel and a totally new field in the process of steel making technology has emerged which is known as tannish metallurgy. Tannish today fulfills certain metallurgical functions such as feeding of the liquid steel to the mold at a controlled rate and with thermal and temperature homogenization. Tannish has also focused on the continuous improvement of many quality related parameters such as fluid dynamics, thermal insulation, intrusion flotation and removal, and hydrogen pickup, etc. Tannish is the large metallurgical vessel through which the liquid steel flows before solidifying in the mold. It has several roles which include a critical link in the steel making change of quality, a continuous refiner, and a transmitter of metallurgical signals. It links the discontinuous process of steel making with the continuous process of continuous casting starting in the mold. And this is often divided into two sections, namely inlet section which has a pore box and where liquid steel is fed into the ladder from the ladder, and two is the outlet section from where liquid steel is fed into the mold. The root of the process remains that an uncontrolled tannish becomes a contaminator rather than a refiner. Tannish is as much a part of stainless steel practices as the ladder before it and is more substance to it. If the quality built up in the steel, making operation is lost, in the tannish, the ability to produce a quality product that meets the intended application depends wholly on recovery of the mold. This is a far more arduous task considering the limited time and the steel resides in the confines of the mold, which provides a finite capability to clean the steel in the last stage prior to complete solidification. The practice for a tannish include tannish lining materials, both permanent working linings, dams, weirs, impact pads, flow control system, mono rod stopper or slide gate, pouring stream production between tannish and mold, slough or submerged entry nozzle, sand, tannish nozzle and sitting rod. Different flow control elements such as dams, weirs, rappers with holes, etc. are normally arranged along the length of the tannish. Longer part of liquid steel is needed to prolong the residence time of liquid steel in the tannish to promote flotation of metal intrusions. Reflective qualities and lining designs have major influence on the parameters such as superheat requirements, task steam speeds, and phenomena like initiator, running stopper, and nozzle clogging, etc. Due to the temperature extremes involved, reflective linings are to be designed to withstand thermal shock, prevent oxidation and thermal loss, and resist erosion and corrosion while preventing the liquid steel getting contaminated with unwanted impurities. Tannish defects are also critical due to the long casting sequence, faster tannish turnaround, Our Tampen life still training us and with us, Tanishta participants should highest perfect thoughts in CCA operation. Tanishta materials has a direct influence on the quality of the electricity since it is close to the solidification stage. Tanishta working line remains in contact with steel and erosion is initiated at the liquid steel air interface with fluctuation of liquid steel level in the Tanishta. Different metallic oxides present in the liquid steel are the primary eroding agents for the Tanishta 49 slab coming in contact with the Tanishta refractory to intestine and the Tanishta covering powder are also responsible for the erosion. Complex interaction at the refractory liquid steel interface can also impair the steel quality due to the formation of the intrusions. Lower erosion of working lining ensures lesser non-metal intrusions in the steel. This figure shows the different areas of tanish and the refractory lining involved and shows the wear, dams and baffles, etc. In the past, when Southern steel making was not fully developed, the tanish was expected to function as a refiner of the deoxidized liquid steel transferred from the ladle, where intrusions were not fully removed. Without ladle furnace processing, the deoxidized liquid steel had micro intrusions and a large number of micro intrusions of indigenous origin that would atomize to form micro intrusions during the liquid steel transfer. Tanish was able to reduce some fraction of the micro intrusions from the liquid steel, adjust chemical composition and control steel temperature to a suitable level for feeding into the mold. With the use of the ladle furnace and or desired liquid steel, cleanliness has significantly improved over the years and Tanish is now seen more as a contaminator than a refiner. The main causes of intrusion formation and contamination of liquid steel include deoxidation products from the steel ladle, ladle lining erosion products, and entanglement of oxidizing slab carried over from the ladle and deoxidation of liquid steel by air. It also includes entanglement of tanish slab by the excessive fluctuation, especially at the inlet zone, deoxidation of steel by air in tanish, precipitation of intrusion at lower temperature, such as TiO2 intrusions, erosion of tanish dyeing, and emulsification of entrained ladle and tanish slab into the liquid steel. Appreciate contamination normally occurs during transient periods of the sequential testing during ladle change at the transition of tool heats. These contaminations or intrusions are required to be floated out of liquid steel during its flow through the tanish before the liquid steel is fed into the mold of the casting machine. With transient period, the incoming liquid steel steam and any liquid matter suppressed are heavily reoxidized by the ambient air and by the oxidizing ladle slag that is carried over into the tanish with the liquid steel. The liquid steel steam hits and aggressively emulsify the ladle slag and tanish slag floating on the liquid steel surface, which eventually gets entrained into the liquid steel. Both the reoxidation and the slag entrainment generate harmful macro oxide intrusions. The aluminium deoxidized liquid steel, even after removal of large particles of deoxidation product in the ladle furnace, contain large number of suspended fine alumina particles. These particles are found to accumulate by turbulent liquid steel flow during the liquid steel transfer from the ladle via the tanish to the mold, forming large alumina clusters. During the transfer of liquid steel through the tanish, it interacts with refractory slag and atmosphere. With continuing emphasis to the quality of steel, it is now increasingly clear that tanish has a far more important function as a continuous reactor than originally envisaged. The proper design and operation of tanish are important for delivering steel of strict composition quality. Modern tanish are designed to provide maximum opportunity for carrying out various methods of operation such as intrusion separation, flotation, alloying, intrusion modification by calcium treatment, superheat control, thermal and composition homogenization leading to the development of a separate area of certainly refining of steel referred as the tanish metallurgy. Design criteria modeling tennis flow controls, flash temperature control, and cleanliness improvements, and non-steady state operations are important aspects of tennis material. This shows a matrices components of a tennis with a stopper rod, slide case, sand, tennis shell, and porous processor. This also shows all the matrices components of the tennis with induction heating and wires, and how the steel is flowing from the ladder to the stopper rods. This also shows a flow of the liquid steel in tennis in and part of the tennis matrices. In order to utilize the tennis as a defining vessel, the following criteria are to be satisfied: elimination of sources of liquid steel contamination, that is effect erosion, deoxidation, ladder slag carryover, and tennis slag emulsification. Promotion of inclusion, flotation, and separation from the liquid steel by means of flow modifying devices, filters, and engineered slag. Introduction of technologies such as thermal control, slag free transfer, and optimized metal delivery system to the mold. Various technologies have been implemented to reduce air reoxidation and slag emulsification. Air reoxidation of the intermediate steel steam is prevented with the use of long nozzle immersed into the electric steel in the tennis or by the shrouded pipe with ardent gas flow. The long nozzle and shrouded pipe also serves to reduce emulsification of the slag into the liquid steel. Flow control devices in the tennis increase the liquid steel resistance time and help in reducing the micro intrusions originating from air deoxidation and slag emulsification. At the same time, thrusters of atomizer and lunar intrusions are reduced by protection of these intrusions. Implementation of active control of the liquid steel temperature in the tennis has also contributed to the thrusting of tennis steel. This shows the flow of the steel in the tennis and how the flotation of the intrusion is taking place. This also shows the flow of the metal from the ladder to the mold, and also shows the dead volume of the tennis and how it is getting replaced with the tennis. The macro intrusions and large aluminum thrusters are known to be major cause of downstream thrusting problems and defects of the strands and their final products. The design and operation of a tennis must be directed towards minimizing formation of the macro intrusions and aluminum thrusters and removing them once they are formed. Intrusions can be removed by the mechanisms which include buoyancy rising and absorption to the top slag, fluid flow control, ardent gas bubble flotation, intrusion growth by torsion and Ostwald ripening and flotation, intrusion absorption to the lining effects. The final intrusion destination includes the top slag, the lining, safe removal, and mold. Possible defects to the task product if not removed in the mold. The flow through a tennis is a hydrodynamic phenomenon. It includes the single phase turbulent fluid flow, multi-phase fluid flow if the gas is injected from the ladder shroud, resistance time distribution, growth of intrusion with its motion and removal, mixing and blade transition, thermal energy transport, and vortexing formation at the start and at the end of the thrusting. Purpose of fluid flow optimization in the tennis is to achieve the best flow pattern to remove intrusions from the system. Flow optimization in the tennis is achieved through the tennis shape and flow control devices such as turbulence inhibitors, impact pads, buffers, wires, and dams. The quality of the steel delivered from the tennis to the mold depends highly on the delay and control of interaction of slag, gas, and effective phases with the steel. A modern tennis is designed to provide maximum opportunity for carrying out various metrics operation and in a way as to realize an optimal flow and therefore higher cleanliness by providing higher average resistance time, small severe turbulence, dead and short circuit volume, large volume of laminar flow regions, post coagulation, in suitable turbulent zones, and protein of inclusion assimilated by cover slab. Avoiding open right eye, taking uncovered surface of the skin against air absorption. Based on sound choice of condition, the operation of a condition needs to be feared to the following to promote inclusion protection by maximize residence time, to ensure inclusion assimilation by attractive and non-traversive slides, to reduce thermal and chemical losses from the liquid steel, to minimize short circuiting and dead zones, to offer the operation and optimal design and quality and yield. Elimination of contamination by air and the refractive phases and technologies to support clean steel practices is part and parcel of sound tennis operations. Thank you for listening to the basis of tennis and tennis maker.